So, Anna Netrebko, this is your first duet recording.
No, and, it was very clear what we really have to sing together on the stage and on the recording. So it's this idea became to be very easy. And
yeah, we decided to put together the duets that we've sung on stage.
And duets which we maybe will never sing on the stage, but we would love to sing this as a concert or on a recording.
One of the challenges of recording in duo is exactly to be in the same symphony, in the same harmony. And you know, sometimes there are takes that you go, ah, this sounded good, but it was not good for me or for her. And I think it has not been a problem. You know, we are listening to everything, and we are looking for the best thing musically for the CD. You know, it's not about who got the biggest note or who got the best sounder. It's about what makes sense dramatically and the expression when it really came together. And I really have found that it's been a very intense work. And because it's two different energies and you have to manage to put the energies together. But it's been really, I mean, for me, it's been a lot of fun.
It's really hard. When I'm trying to keep my high notes, he always trying to have you see. And he asking me all the time, can I try one, three times, five times? And I say, listen, I have a limit with my voice, you know? It's really difficult, you know? After all your cracks there, you know, it's impossible. It's so much easier to record alone.
Yeah. You should. Why did you record a CD with this colleague that is so terrible for you? Okay, who holds the high note always a little bit longer than the other? You! Always! It's always like... Oh,
what was that?
Ah, it's Anna Netrebko cutting the note 1 second after the tenor. Ah, it is true. The proof is in the tapes, the pirate tapes.
Because soprano voice running faster. Maestro say the Bohème is for the young people. You can really feel the story and understand. And we feel just perfect in there. That was actually easy. We record this almost from the first track.
This is a duet we've sung several times in concerts together. And we did the complete opera in St. Petersburg. And I invited me to sing Rodolfo there. And I have to say it was...
Great success. People still talking about that.
I think Anna puts a special energy and imagination into the character of Mimi. And so it makes it richer, a different lecture of it that works very well with the music.
And you, how many Rodolfos you sung? Like 15 productions?
Yeah, like 15 productions and over 100 performances. But it was one of my first roles. It's one of the roles I've sung the most. And it's, you know, every time I sing it, it's still something new there.
New sopranos. New body.
New energy. Different lectures about the character. Così dolce restar qui, c'è
freddo fuori.
Before Mimi, you sang tons of musettas. A lot of musettas? Did you sing a lot of musettas?
Many.
Yeah.
Almost and like you made, your Rodolfo's.
Yeah. And you made quite a character with musetta. I mean, people still talk about your musettas in San Francisco, at the Met, everywhere. And so now, which character do you feel more closer to you, the musetta or Mimi?
I love both of them. If you will combine them together, there is the character. But of course, musically, Mimi is much more interesting, and I'm very happy to now to switch. This is the time to switch.
So we're singing in French, in Italian,
Spanish, and Russian.
We have Bordeaux, vodka, tequila, and grappa.
All of them are mixed. Wonderful cocktail. The idea of Iolanta came because it's only one duet in Russian music for soprano and tenor from Iolanta, and we decided to do it. It's very, very difficult. Even for the Russian speaking, it's very hard. But Rolando was so fantastic. I'm very proud of you, really, of your Russian and of your style and of your singing. It was really, really great.
And so I was in Madrid listening to Maestro Domingo singing Luisa Fernanda, and suddenly the duet came and I said, of course, I mean, this duet is fantastic. And so I said to Anna, we have to do this recording, we have to do this this duet. And, you know, I came here, she said, you will help me with the Spanish. And of course, she starts singing like, it's like, you will help me with my Spanish. Even the intentions, I mean, I told you, ay, da 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 da. Fantastic.
Maybe I was a Spanish in the past life.
No. And I was a Russian. No, I'm sure I have more accent than in my Russian than you in your Spanish. For sure, I can bet on that.
Thank you.
It's this magic mirror. And when you tell a lie in front of the mirror sucks you and you disappear. So the soprano comes and says, I think I am the best Gilda that has ever sung this part in the history of opera. The baritone comes and says, I think I am the best Rigoletto that has ever put a foot on stage. The tenor comes and says, I think.
Ha 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 ha